Hey guys, Matt from Atlas Precision Consulting. In this video, I'm going to show you kind of the basics of a credit and rebill. But before we get in there and actually do the credit and rebill, I want to call your attention to a setting under System Settings and Accounts Receivable General. It's called the default invoice date for credit and rebills. Currently in this environment, we have it set to invoice at the current date, but you can also set it to use the original invoice date. Now, it's important to know that even if you use today's current date for the rebill, it still keeps the original invoices net and term dates. And I'll show you what that looks like. So we're going to leave that as current date. And so we're going to come into our credit and rebill. I'm going to put in our invoice number. Now you can see Merry Christmas to us. The date is December 25th. Now when I watch what happens to the date when I check the credit and rebill, it changes it to today's current date, which is the 26th of January. But if we look at the terms, you can see where the terms and net due date are still the 24th. And I'll show you once we're done processing this that it still keeps those dates. We're going to have a reason code. We're going to say this is a unit price, but you can also use this to easily fix some tax issues. Customer called to inform us that these are supposed to be 5 cents a piece, not 5 cents a piece, or $5 a piece, excuse me. So what we're going to do is we're changing our price. We're going to see what our new extended price is going to be. I'm going to hit save on here. And you'll see what it'll do is it'll create a new invoice, and that new invoice will reference the original invoice number. So that way, if a check comes in from a customer and you go to apply that payment, it's still going to link to the new rebill invoice. They are linked behind the system. But you can see that the due date on here is still the 24th. And to confirm that, we can grab this new rebill invoice number, come back into our credit and rebill, and we can see that even though the invoice number on that is the 26th, if we go to the terms, you see that it's still the 24th. Credit rebill is a great thing in P21. It prevents you from having to do a lot of returns and new orders and re-invoicing and things like that. So if you guys have any more questions about this topic or you want to see some videos on some other topics, put it in the comments below. As always, make sure you like and subscribe to the channel so you can watch all of our upcoming videos. And if you need any help with Profit 21, we would be more than willing to help you guys. Thanks.